afternoon, everyone. I am audible.
Good afternoon.
Okay, so welcome you all to the Department of Mathematics for your open elective paper, which is nothing but the fundamental of mathematics. Okay, so myself is Vishal Kodi. Actually, the students from MCA first are familiar with me since I have taken one paper of first year, which is nothing but the discrete mathematical structure. Okay, now in this semester I will take your fundamentals in mathematics. Let us see the syllabus. Okay, so this will be our paper, which is nothing but the fundamentals in mathematics, in which first unit is nothing but the, which is actually depending on our matrices, in which we have to see elementary matrix operations and elementary matrices, types of matrices and determinants, rank of a matrix and matrix inverses. Okay, so this unit is actually somewhat part of this topic is already we have seen in discrete mathematical structures. That is, what is a matrix, some basic types of matrices, that is row matrix, column matrix, scalar matrix, identity matrix, we have already seen. Just we have to extend this one. Okay, and here in discrete mathematical structure we have seen what is a determinant, but we don't know how to find out the rank of a matrix and what is actually the meaning of rank. Okay, and after that the last point, which is nothing but the matrix inverses, and we have studied one method, which is by adjoint method. So there are so many methods for finding the inverse of a matrix. By row operation and column operation we can also find out the matrix inverse. Okay, so this will be our first unit. In second unit we have to see solution of system of simultaneous linear homogeneous equation and solution of system of simultaneous linear non-homogeneous equation. If ax plus by will be equal to c and c is not equal to 0, then the corresponding equation is nothing but non-homogeneous, and if c will be equal to 0, that is a plus by will be equal to 0, then the given system of linear equation is nothing but the homogeneous, and from that one we have to find out the corresponding solutions by using the matrix method. Okay, so this will be our second unit. In third unit we have to see what is a vector space, subspace, linear combination, linear dependence and linear independence of vectors, and from that we have to see what is a basis. Okay, first we have to see what are the linearly independent vectors and when they are said to be a, when they are form a basis for a given vector space, and if they form a basis then what should be its dimension, that is we have to see. Actually these are the concepts which are dependent on each other. Okay, first we have to see vector space. If we have a vector space, then from that we have to find out the subspace, that is actually subspace itself also a vector space, and we have to see which space will be a subspace of another space, and from that one we have to see what is a linear combination of vectors belonging to our given corresponding vector space, and if they, we have some n, we have a set containing n vectors, then we have to check whether the given n vectors are linearly dependent or linearly independent. If they are linearly independent, then they must be member of our basis set. Okay, if the basis set has a dimension n, then the corresponding n vector itself are the basis elements, but if it has a dimension more than n elements, then there are some elements which are not belonging to that set having n vectors. Okay, so this will be our third unit, and in last unit we have to see the linear transformation, and for linear transformation we require, first it is a function, and as it is a function then it must have a domain and codomain. Then we define a mapping T which is from one set A to B, but here linear transformation is a function, but there is a necessary condition on its domain and codomain, that is its domain and codomain must be a vector space, then only we can define a function F which is from one vector space to another vector space, and it holds two conditions, then corresponding function is said to be a linear transformation on that particular vector spaces, and from that one we have to see what is a null space, range space and matrix representation of linear transformation. If we have a linear transformation, then from that one we have to convert a given linear transformation in terms of matrix, and if we have a matrix, then we have to form a linear transformation from that matrix. So this will be our four units, and we will start from our first unit, which is nothing but the matrix. Okay, before going to our actual syllabus, we will see some basic concepts. Screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so see some basic concept. Now, either we can start a matrix or a vector space. We require first a set. So, what is a set? फास्ट होत असेल तर सांगा तेव्हाच नाही सीट तर तुम्हाला सगळ्यांना माहित असेल स्टॅटच्या स्टुडंटना तर काही प्रॉब्लेम नसेल जर स्टॅटच्या स्टुडंट ही ओपन इलेक्टिव्ह साठी फंडामेंटल असेल मॅथमॅटिक्स चूज केला असेल तर त्या सेटशी ती तर फॅमिलीअर आहे आणखी एमसीएला तर ऑलरेडी आपण लास्ट पेपर मध्ये डिस्क्रिप्टिव्ह मॅथमॅटिक्स मध्ये सेट त्याचे टाईप पूर्ण बघितले सो व्हॉट इज अ सेट
इट इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ नंबर्स व्हेरिएबल्स
कलेक्शन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स
कलेक्शन प्रत्येक कलेक्शन ऑब्जेक्टचं प्रत्येक कलेक्शन हे सेट होतं का जर समजा मी सेट हा घेतला आणि त्यामध्ये अशी कंडिशन घातली की त्यामध्ये एका क्लासमध्ये सर्व हाइटेड मुलं आहेत तर तो करस्पॉन्डिंग जो ये आहे तो सेट फॉर्म करेल का हाइटेड स्टुडंट घातलं परंतु मी रिस्ट्रिक्शन नाही दिलं की हाईट किती असायला पाहिजे तर तो सेट फॉर्म करेल का सेट इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ वेल डिफाइंड कलेक्शन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स well-defined collection of objects. जर तुम्हाला त्या मुलांच्या हाईट जर सेट बनवायचं असेल तर तुम्हाला पर्टिक्युलर हाईट सांगावं लागेल की त्या हाईट आणखी त्या हाईटच्या पुढचे मुलं त्या करस्पॉन्डिंग सेटमध्ये असतील अदरवाईज तो सेट फॉर्म करणार ओके सपोज दिस वन इज अ सेट देन व्हॉट इज अ सबसेट we have two sets A and B. Then when we say that A is a subset of B. Let capital A and capital B be two sets. Suppose we have to say A is a subset of B. Then when we say capital A is a subset of a set capital B. सेट हा दुसऱ्या सेटचा सबसेट कधी होतो स्टॅटिस्टिकची मुलं आहेत ना एव्हरी एलिमेंट ऑफ सेट ए इज बिलॉंगिंग टू सेट बी देन वी से दॅट द करस्पॉन्डिंग सेट ए इज अ सबसेट ऑफ सेट बी देन ए इज subset of B if each element of A is an element of set dot set B then we see that the corresponding set B is a subset of a set B okay before going to types of states we'll see some number systems if we see the number system then it is easier to do the example of to give the examples of sets okay first one is nothing but the set of natural numbers what is the set of natural number
1 2 3 4 5 6
the counting numbers which are nothing but 1 2 3 4 which is nothing but which is denoted by this gen and having elements are 1, 2, 3, 4. Next number system will be set of integers. What is a set of integers? which is denoted by shade, and it contains the number. All the natural numbers plus 0 plus all the negative natural numbers. That is 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus 3. 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus 3 and up to so on. This one is nothing but the set of integer. Third number system will be a set of rational numbers. What are the natural numbers? Sorry, rational numbers. Set of rational number is denoted by Q, and it contains all the elements of the form 0
by
0 P by Q, where there is a restriction on Q. Q is not equal to 0. If Q will be equal to 0, then this term will be not defined, that is P by Q is not defined. So here Q is not equal to 0. Q 0 असेल तर काय आवाज क्लियर येतो तुमचा
मी माझी बोलू 0 एंड के एंड क्यू आर इरेशनल नंबर
सॉरी तुमचा आवाज नाही आला पी एंड क्यू कसले नंबर असते
इरेशनल नंबर इंटीजर नंबर सॉरी
इंटीजर असतात ना इरेशनल नंबर आणखीन डिफाइनच नाही केला
Here
P comma Q are belonging to set of integers. And what is the GCD of P and Q? कि जो हम P by Q तो मैं define करता था, हमारे अच्छे GCD पर कई तरह restriction आता. What is the GCD? GCD means greatest common divisor. The GCD of P and Q must be equal to one. Then only they are of the form P by Q. Otherwise they will be of the form they will be integer. Okay. Now fourth one, set of irrational number. Which are denoted by either I or Q complement. What are the set of irrational numbers? Set of irrational numbers contains all the numbers of the type P by Q. But in rational number, if we take P by Q, then after some finite number of steps, that is digit पॉइंट सम डिजिटच्या नंतर तुमचं जे काही आहे ते एंड होईल कुठेतरी किंवा नंबर रिपीट होतील. पण इरॅशनल नंबर मध्ये तुम्ही जर घेतला पी बाय क्यू घेतला तर डेसिमल डिजिटच्या नंतर एक ही नंबर रिपीट ही होत नाही, आणखीन कुठेच ती प्रोसेस थांबत नाही, म्हणजे पूर्णपणे भागी जात नाही. पॉइंट नंतर ही पूर्णपणे कुठेही भाग जाणार नाही, आणखीन कोणताही नंबर रिपीट होत नाही. कारण फॉर एक्झाम्पल जर 0.11 जर येत असेल तर आपण इथे प्रोसेस स्टॉप करतो असं. पण इरॅशनल नंबरच्या बाबतीत असं होत नाही. 0.1234 असे डिस्टिंक्ट डिजिटच मिळत जातील. काही वेळेनंतर हे डिजिट रिपीट होतील, परंतु असं कुठेच येणार नाही 0.44 0.133. सो सच टाइप ऑफ नंबर्स आर कॉल्ड द सेट ऑफ इरॅशनल नंबर. ओके, फिफ्थ वन, सेट ऑफ रियल नंबर्स. Okay, so what is the set of real number? It is just a union of both the sets Q and Q complement. That is set of rational number plus set of irrational number is nothing but the set of real numbers. It includes both the rational and irrational number, and the corresponding set is nothing but the set of real numbers. And the last number system, which is nothing but the set of complex numbers. What is a complex number? Complex number चा form काय असतो? It contains all the elements of the type A plus IB, where A and B are members of
real.
Okay, so this one is nothing but the complex number. Now, by the definition of subset, tell me which one is the subset of which set. Whether set of natural number is a subset of set of integer, or set of integer is a subset of set of natural number?
So there is one number system is missing. One number.
होल नंबर ऍक्च्युअली ते सेट अप इंटीजर मध्ये येते म्हणून मी होल नंबर घेतला नाही. जर घ्यायचा असेल तर घेऊ शकतो होल नंबर्स. जस्ट वे हॅव टू ऍड अँड झिरो इन सेट अप नॅचरल नंबर देन द करस्पॉन्डिंग नंबर सिस्टम इज नथिंग बट होल नंबर इज नथिंग बट 0 1 2 3 अप टू सो ऑन. Okay, let us denote this one as a W. Now, whether set of natural number is a subset of whole number or set of whole number is a subset of natural number?
Set of natural number is subset of set of integers.
Set of integers. Set of integer and what is the relation between set of integer and set of rational number? Whether every integer is rational or every rational is integer? Or there is no relation in between the two sets, that is set of integers and set of rational numbers. Yes, every natural is integer, but what is the relation between integer and rational? Or there is no relation in between the corresponding sets. Rational number and integer madhe kay relation asto? Pratyek integer ha rational number asto ka?
Yes sir.
Nakki na? What about converse? Whether every rational number is integer? जर प्रत्येक तुमच्या म्हणण्यानुसार प्रत्येक इंटीजर हा रॅशनल असतो तो ठीक आहे. जर प्रत्येक रॅशनल ही जर इंटीजर होत असेल तर ही नवीन नंबर सिस्टीम काढायची गरजच नसती पडली ना. कारण काहीतरी अशी गोष्टी आहेत की जे सेट ऑफ इंटीजर मध्ये नाहीये त्याचा अर्थ काहीतरी नवीन गोष्टी मिळाली जी सेट ऑफ रॅशनल नंबर मध्ये. त्याचा अर्थ प्रत्येक रॅशनल नंबर हा इंटीजर होत नाही. फॉर एक्झाम्पल वी टेक पी इक्वल टू 1 अँड क्यू इक्वल टू 2, देन इट इज अ नंबर ऑफ द फॉर्म 1/2 अँड दिस टाइप ऑफ नंबर्स आर नॉट बिलॉंगिंग टू सेट ऑफ integers. Therefore every rational number is not an integer, but each integer is a rational number, since each integer can be written as, if suppose 2 and 3 are integers, then we can write this one as 2 by 1 3 by 1. So they are of the form p by q, where q will be equal to 1, then they must be rational numbers. So every integer is a rational number, but converse need not be true. Okay, now is there is any relation in between rational and irrational numbers?
No sir.
Okay, both are distinct. Now, set of real numbers. All the sets which are we have seen, that is set of rational numbers, set of irrational numbers, set of integers, set of whole numbers, and set of natural numbers. All the subsets of set of real numbers. Since set of real number is nothing but the union of two sets, which are nothing but set of rational number and set of irrational number. And all the sets, that is set of natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers, are the subsets of rational numbers, and a set of real number contains all the rational numbers, then all those sets are subsets of set of real number, where A and B are belonging to R, where this I is nothing but the imaginary unit. Capital small A is called the real part of complex number, and B is called the imaginary part of complex number, since its coefficient will be imaginary unit. But whenever we will take B will be equal to 0, then it is of the form A plus I into 0 whenever A is belonging to curly R. Therefore, this set will forms a whole real number when B will be equal to 0. Then what is the relation between set of real number and set of complex number? Whether every real number is a complex number. रियल नंबर आणि कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर मध्ये काय रिलेशन? प्रत्येक रियल नंबर हा कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर होईल का?
नो सर.
जर बोलत असेल तर तुमच्याकडे एक एक्झाम्पल असायला पाहिजे की असा एक रियल नंबर आहे जो कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर नाही. सेट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर काय आहे ए प्लस आय बी आहे ए आणखी बी कोणाचे नंबर आर चे जर तुम्ही बी इक्वल टू झिरो केला तर हे काय होईल ए प्लस आय झिरो म्हणजेच हा सेट काय होईल यामध्ये प्रत्येक ए असेल जो ए बिलॉंग करेल कर्ली आर म्हणजे सेट ऑफ रिअल नंबर बट ऑल रिअल नंबर्स म्हणजे माझा सेट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर हा सेट ऑफ रिअल नंबर बनतो म्हणजे सेट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर हाच सेट ऑफ रिअल नंबर होईल कधी जर बी इक्वल टू झिरो असेल तर आणखी जर बी हा नॉन झिरो असेल तर माझ्याकडे असे नंबर असतील जे की रिअल नंबर मध्ये नसतील ओके सो सेट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर ऑब्विसली सेट ऑफ रिअल नंबर पेक्षा मोठा आहे आणखी हा पूर्ण रिअल नंबर देतो कधी जर बी इक्वल टू झिरो असेल तर याचा अर्थ प्रत्येक रिअल नंबर हा माझा कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर होईल सो देन बाय द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सबसेट सेट ऑफ नॅचरल नंबर्स आर द सबसेट्स ऑफ सेट ऑफ होल नंबर्स विच आर सबसेट्स ऑफ विच इज अ सबसेट ऑफ सेट ऑफ इंटीजर विच इज अगेन अ सबसेट ऑफ रॅशनल नंबर बट देर इज नो रिलेशन इन बिटवीन रॅशनल अँड इरॅशनल नंबर सिमिलरली नन अमंग दीज सेट्स दॅट इज नॅचरल होल अँड इंटीजर्स इज अ सबसेट ऑफ irrational number therefore this set of rational number is a subset directly subset of a set of real numbers since r is nothing but q union q dash that is it is a union of rational and irrational and set of real number is a subset of set of complex number okay so this will be a relation in between these number systems okay and in the graphical representation of real number system and complex number system graphical representation of real number system is just a single line that is we can represent by the real numbers on just a single line suppose this will be a line l1 then for each point in this line there is a one real number suppose this here somewhere will be our origin that is zero and these are the points on the real line प्रत्येक पॉइंटच्या करस्पॉन्डिंग मला एक रिअल नंबर मिळेल आणखी प्रत्येक रिअल नंबरच्या करस्पॉन्डिंग एक पॉइंट असेल या लाईनवर म्हणजे ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन जो आहे रिअल नंबर सिस्टमचा तो प्रत्येक लाईनवर तुम्ही एक्सप्रेस करू शकता तुम्हाला प्रत्येक रिअल नंबरच्या बाबतीत एक पॉइंट त्या लाईनवर मिळेल आणि कोणताही जर पॉइंट त्या लाईनवरून घेतला तर तुम्हाला एक करस्पॉन्डिंग रिअल नंबर मिळेल बट फॉर कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर ॲज कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर आर ऑफ द फॉर्म ए प्लस आय बी and abr members of r then they must be belong into two dimensional space that is for this require two dimensional space that is this will be x axis and this will be y okay and if suppose we have one complex number z which is equal to some a plus ib a plus ib suppose here is our a and here is our b since this will be a real axis real axis and this one is nothing but the imaginary okay so as a is a real number then it must be belong in the it must be here okay now we can represent this number the complex number can also represented can be also expressed as a ordered pairs that is ab where a is a real part b is a imaginary part and here somewhere is our ordered pair a comma b okay so okay up to now any doubt aata parent kunal kahi doubt sorry first we will see for finite set what is a finite set and it is nothing but a set having finite number of elements that is for example we save A, which contains some finite number of elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, n. Okay, so this will be a finite set. What is an infinite set? Is it having infinite number of elements? This set having infinite number of elements. So if we take any example from this number system, that is set of natural number, whole number, integer, rational, irrational, real, complex, all are the sets with infinite number of elements. Therefore, its examples are natural number, real number, complex number, whole number, set of rational numbers. And okay. So this will be an infinite. Okay. Now, tell me what is the relation? What is the relation? Suppose we have two sets A and B. What is the relation from A to B? The relation from A to B is a subset of Cartesian product A cross B. Relation from capital A to B is a subset of Cartesian product A cross B. What is a Cartesian product? A cross B means it contains all the numbers of the type that is ordered pair AB, where A is belonging to our capital A and B is belonging to our capital B. Okay, so such type of set is nothing but the Cartesian product of two sets A and B. And if we take any subset of this A cross B, then that will be a relation from set A to set B. So this will be a relation. What is the function? Again, we require two sets. Let A and B be two sets. Okay. Then, what is the function from A to B? If there exists a correspondence from A to B such that for each element in A has a unique element in B. Okay, so if we have two sets A and B, and if there exists a correspondence F, which is from set A to set B, such that for each element in capital A has a unique element in capital B. That is, every element in capital A has a unique image in B, then we say that the corresponding mapping F is a function from set A to set B. Okay, that is, suppose here somewhere is our domain capital A, sorry, capital A, and here is our B. Okay, and this will be a given correspondence. Yep, and here he suppose there are some elements, either they are finite or infinite. Okay, so suppose A, B, C are three elements, and here there are some. Okay, now this correspondence here, under this correspondence here, if each element in capital A has a unique image in capital B, or for each element A has unique element in some B, that is, if A is mapped on this one, B is mapped on two, C is mapped on this three. Okay, so each element in capital A has a image in capital B and which is unique. Okay, then we say that the corresponding F is a function from A to B and which is denoted by this symbol, F from A to B. Okay, now if suppose जर एच्या प्रत्येक एलिमेंटसाठी जर मला एक एलिमेंट बी मध्ये मिळत असेल, ज्यासाठी जर म्हणजे दिलेल्या फंक्शनच्या दिलेल्या मॅपिंगच्या अंडर जर मॅप होत असेल, तर करस्पॉन्डिंग एफला मी काय म्हणणार, फंक्शन, कुठून कुठपर्यंत, ए टू बी पासून. म्हणजे प्रत्येक एलिमेंटसाठी युनिकच इमेज मिळालेली पाहिजे. असं झालं नाही पाहिजे की हा ए वन वरही जातो आणि ए थ्री वरही जातो. जर असं होत असेल तर दिलेलं एफ हा फंक्शन नसणार. ओके, फॉर एक्झाम्पल इफ वी टेक एफ इज अ फंक्शन फ्रॉम sorry, F is a mapping from some set open interval 0,1 to closed 0,1. Let us extend this interval, that is 0 to 4, and it is again 0 to 4. What we require, and F of X is equal to root X. Okay, now if we take the element 2 which is belonging to domain to open interval 0, 4. So what is f of 4? Sorry, take this one as a close. If we take the close one, then only we can take the element 4, and which is equal to under root of 4. What is under root of 4? Under root 4 kaya to plus 2 ka minus 2. A plus or minus doni.
Plus minus 2.
Plus or minus 2 a. ओके, सो अंडर रूट ऑफ 4 इज नथिंग बट प्लस ऑर मायनस 2. सो मला दिलेल्या फंक्शन, सॉरी फंक्शन तर नाहीये हा, दिलेली मॅपिंग काय माझी, एफ ऑफ एक्स विल बी इक्वल टू रूट एक्स आहे. डोमेन ज्याचा ओपन 0 क्लोज 4 आहे, आणि को डोमेन क्लोज 0 क्लोज 4 आहे. जर मी एफ ऑफ 4 हा एलिमेंट घेतला, तर एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ 4, ज्यासाठी मला दोन एलिमेंट पाहिजे. म्हणजे माझा हा जर डोमेन असेल हा ओपन इंटरवल 0 अँड क्लोज 4, आणखी इकडला जो माझा को डोमेन असेल क्लोज 0 क्लोज 4, इथं जो एलिमेंट आहे 4, यासाठी मला इथं दोन एलिमेंट मिळाले. इथं कुठंतरी प्लस 2 आहे, इथं कुठंतरी मायनस 2 आहे. आणखी हा एकच एलिमेंट हा ऍट अ टाइम दोन ठिकाणी मॅप होईल. ओके, देन विच कॉन्ट्राडिक्ट्स टू अवर डेफिनेशन ऑफ फंक्शन. सिन्स डेफिनेशन ऑफ फंक्शन इज नथिंग बट फॉर ईच एलिमेंट इन ए हॅज अ युनिक एलिमेंट इन बी, बट हिअर वी हॅव टू एलिमेंट्स विच आर द इमेजेस ऑफ अन एलिमेंट. So, therefore, this will be a not a function. Okay. B, then this A is called a domain and B is called coder. Okay. Now, what is a binary operation?
It contains two numbers, 0 and 1.
If GBN is safe, then what is a binary operation? Suppose GBN is safe, then G cross G is nothing but it contains all the ordered pairs AB, where first A is this A is belonging to first G and B is belonging to second. So this will be a Cartesian product of set G, that is G by G. Now we have to define a binary operation. Suppose F is a mapping from the set G by G to G, then this F is called a binary operation on G. Binary operation That is, if we take any two elements belonging to G, then under this operation, that is this one, F is a operation. Under this operation, if this will be closed, then the given operation will be a binary operation. म्हणजे जर माझ्याकडे एक ऑपरेशन काहीतरी प्लस डॉट डिव्हिजन मल्टिप्लिकेशन जो काही दिलाय तो दिलाय तो बायनरी ऑपरेशन कधी होईल जर एखादा सेट असेल आणखी त्या सेटमधून मी कोणतेही दोन एलिमेंट घेतले आणखी तो बायनरी ऑपरेशन जर त्यावर सॉरी तो ऑपरेशनवर जर त्यावर अप्लाय केला आणखी तो एलिमेंट जो ऑपरेशन केल्यानंतर जो फायनली एलिमेंट मिळणार आहे तो एलिमेंट सुद्धा जर त्या करस्पॉन्डिंग सेटमध्येच येत असेल तर तो जो आपला ऑपरेशन आहे तो बायचा बायनरी ऑपरेशन. फॉर एक्झाम्पल इफ सपोज वी हॅव प्लस इज operation and which is defined from G cross G to G, where G is a set having elements 1 to suppose G is a set which is a natural number. G is nothing but the natural number. Now if we take any two natural number belonging to this G, that is A and B are natural numbers, then addition of these two natural number, addition of two natural number is again a natural number. Therefore, the given operation plus is a binary operation on that set. Okay, and the binary operation is generally denoted by plus dot composition star whatever it will be. Okay, so this will be a binary operation. Now, what is the algebraic structure? A non-empty set with one or more binary operations it's called a algebraic structure. Okay, so what is the algebraic structure? If we have one set G which is non-empty, non-empty means it has at least one element, and if suppose there are one or more than one binary operations are defined on that set, then the corresponding set is said to be a algebraic structure. For example, n plus set of natural number with respect to addition is algebraic structure. Similarly, set of real numbers with two binary operation plus and dot is again a algebraic structure, since addition of two real number is again a real number and a multiplication of two real number is again a real number. Therefore, plus and dot are the binary operations on the set of real numbers, and as they are both are the binary operations on set of real numbers, then the triplet R plus dot is called an algebraic structure. So these are the examples of algebraic structure. Now we have to define a concept which is nothing but group. What is a group? Let G be any non-empty set. Let G with binary operation star is a algebraic structure. Then G forms a group under the binary operation star if it holds the following properties. Which are those? First one is nothing but closure property. Closure property or closure law. And it states that if A and we are any two elements of G, then A star B is also belonging to G. That is, A B belonging to G implies A star B is also belonging to G. Then we say that the given set is closed under closure property. Second one is associative property. Associative law. Let A, B, C are any three elements of G. A, comma, B, comma, C belong to G. Then A star B star C equal to A star B star C for all A, B, C belonging to G. Then if it holds this condition, then the corresponding G is closed under the associative property. And third one is nothing but existence of identity. Identity. Okay. So, for any element, each element A in G, there exists an element. Element E. Which is belonging to G such that A star E equal to E star A equal to E. Okay, जर प्रत्येक कोणताही एलिमेंट जर मी घेतला G मधून तर त्यासाठी मला एक एलिमेंट E असा मिळतो G मधून ज्यासाठी A star E किंवा E star E. Under this binary operation A star E and A star A is always give the value A, then the corresponding E is said to be an identity element, which implies E is an identity element. Identity. If we have existing identity, then the last property, which is nothing but the existence of inverse. And this one is nothing but for each element, small a in G. There exists an element B in G such that A star B equal to B star A equal to E. Okay, जर कोणताही element A घेतला G मधून तर त्यासाठी मला एक element मिळाला पाहिजे ज्यांच्यावर दोघांवर operation केल्यानंतर मला identity element मिळाला पाहिजे E. तर माझा B हा inverse होईल A चा और A हा inverse असेल B चा. Simplify. B is inverse of A. Inverse of A. That is, A is also inverse of B. And if any set holds all these four properties, then it is a, it forms a group with respect to given binary operation. Okay. So which implies G with binary operation star forms a group. Okay, since it holds the above four properties, and if it is holds the fifth property, which is a commutative property, law, that is, A and B are any two members of G, which implies A star B is equal to B star A, then we say that the corresponding G holds the commutative property, and if G is closed under this property, then we say that, which implies G with binary operation star is a abelian group. Okay, Kunal, kahi doubt yamadhe? Yes, I'm going to understand the chapter.